we've been doing blind retrieves, Ian, and a lot of it has been blind retrieves on dummies and so forth. Now, many times when you're shooting, you might have a mate shoot one to the side, which the dog doesn't see. It flushes a bird or it flushes a rabbit at the side. That's more tempting. That's more distracting. You've got to try and say to it, forget that one. Go for this one. How are you going to do that?
Well, like, we just come at rabbit pen now. We'll hunt the dog along and then drop a dummy. Hunt on and flush a rabbit.
Mm-hmm.
When the dog's flushed the rabbit try to make it so it runs the opposite way. You said bring the dog back to you, leave the rabbit and handle it and send it back for the dummy.
Right.
And it's just a bit more tempting. It's just like another advanced stage onto your handling retrieves on game and that. And well, this is the best place I've done it before we start shooting over them properly.
So you've been building up to that. I know that when you did the unseens, you actually did throw a ball to the side now and again.
That's it.
And then sent them for, and you only picked it yourself. So you've built up to this. So it should be a little straightforward, but there's a hell of a temptation from a live game.
A lot of the time they go after the rabbits and things like that. You've just to learn them. If you've done your work outside properly, they take to this like a duck to water. But if you've not done your own work in the first place properly, this proves ever so difficult. Leave that. Rosie, get out. Hello, host. Good girl. Here, Rosie. Good girl, Rosie. Stay. Yeah, leave that. Here, Rosie. Leave. Rosie, get out. Get out. Get out. Get out. Get out. Get out. Hello, host. Good girl, here, Rosie, good girl, Rosie, come on, good girl, Good girl. Good girl.